Hello, everyone. My name is Colleen Williams, and I'm a program manager on the Microsoft Edge team. Happy to be speaking with you at this Ignite. I want to talk with you about top reasons why customers love Microsoft Edge and what we've heard over the last year directly from customers. To start, we celebrated our one-year birthday in January. In January of 2020, we released Edge on Chromium after announcing in December of 2018 that we were moving to the Chromium open source project. 2019 saw us release preview builds, including Canary, Dev, Beta, and finally the Stable Channel in January of 2020. It's been a big year. I've been on the team for a very long time, and seeing the growth, learnings, and customer response to Microsoft Edge has been heartwarming, and I want to thank you for helping us, providing feedback, and your willingness to learn and grow along with us. NPS has improved 30 points over the last year. So again, thank you, and please continue to help us in our journey. I want to make sure everyone knows where we are. We are everywhere. We're on Windows Client, Windows Server, Mac, iOS, Android, and most recently, M1 Mac devices. We also released preview builds of Linux in October. I also want to make sure everyone is aware of IE mode. There are lots of line of business applications that need IE 11 for whatever reason. And a recent total economic impact survey conducted by Forrester Consulting on behalf of Microsoft in January 2021 reports an average cost of $335,000 to modernize one website or application. Now imagine if you have hundreds or even thousands of these sites. It can be overwhelming to think about. The good news is IE mode is available in Edge on Chromium. This allows your users to use one browser for both backward compatibility as well as for modern sites. You can consolidate down to one browser without spending money to modernize these LOB apps, and IE 11 isn't needed any longer. Later on in the presentation, I'm going to show you how to disable IE 11 in your environment without it affecting IE mode. And if you do need something, we have more resources available. I speak with customers every day. That's my job. And what we've heard repeatedly from many different customers is not only is Edge an amazing product, but the offerings from Microsoft helps in making the decision to have Edge in their environment easier. Let's go through these programs. We have Aperture. So if a site works in IE 11, Google Chrome, or any version of Edge, it absolutely should work in Edge on Chromium. If not, give the Aperture team a call. We have Fast Track available to help you with your deployment efforts. If you are a Windows customer that's purchased 150 plus seats for your enterprise, go ahead and call the Fast Track team and they'll help you with your deployment. And finally, Unified Support. The beta and stable channels of Edge are supported through the Unified Support and already included in your support contract. No additional cost. The amount of support available from Aperture, Fast Track, and Unified Support, along with an amazing product, is often called out as a key component in customers' decision-making. We even had one customer tell us that they are saving hundreds of thousands of dollars in support costs by canceling a different vendor's support contract. While it's important to understand what we've been doing with Edge on Chromium and where we're going, it's important to understand what's happening over the next few months with Edge Legacy. If you rely on Edge Legacy, please make sure you are aware of what's happening over the next few months. Visit aka.ms/EdgeLegacyEOS, which goes into detail what to expect when. You'll see by the end of the presentation that Edge has what you need, and you can easily transition from Edge Legacy to Edge on Chromium. First things first, when you have a product, it needs to be secure. In this next section, I'm going to talk about the security features in Edge and why customers love these features. Edge protects corporate resources, data, and end users, and customers are choosing Edge based on the privacy and security reputation from Microsoft. Having Edge as part of your M365 portfolio lessens the reliance on other third-party applications or plugins. It's a natural fit. We're living in a new reality. We can no longer believe everything behind the corporate firewall is safe. We can't keep operating under the old principles, and we need new principles. There are three pillars to look at. Verify explicitly. Always authenticate and authorize based on available data points. Those points can be user identity, location, device health, service or workload, data classification, and anomalies. The second pillar is use least privileged access. Limit user access with just-in-time and just enough access to protect both data and productivity. And lastly, assume breach, minimize blast radius for breaches, and employ security strategy to prevent lateral movement. Our security technology works together to provide the right solution for customers and has been recognized as best in class by many influential analysts, including Forrester, Kuppinger Cole, and 451 Research. Here you can see how Gartner has designated Microsoft as a leader in five key security and compliance magic quadrants: access management, cloud access security broker, enterprise information archiving, endpoint protection platforms, and unified endpoint management tools. Microsoft Edge is held to the same high bar. One of the main concerns when working on browsers is the potential for a security incident. The average cost of a data breach is around $3.86 million. Browsers remain a vulnerable surface for bad actors to access the corporate network, data, and information. In addition, end users can accidentally share data. It's very easy to trick a user to click something, open something, save something, etc., that makes the computer and data unsafe. We've all done it, much to the chagrin of our red teams. Security is always a concern, and Edge helps with that. In fact, Edge is more secure than Google Chrome for your business on Windows 10. Let's talk about the Edge features that customers rely on day-to-day to keep their businesses secure and compliant. Smart Screen. This is an industry-leading and top-rated anti-phishing and anti-malware support feature. This is a reputation-based URL and app protection feature that blocks unwanted apps and sites. Application Guard. Natively supported in Edge and allows for sites that are on an untrusted site list to open in a separate container. With this feature, Edge makes sure there's no access to CorpNet resources of any kind. We've added in additional features based on feedback from customers, such as extension support, diagnostic page for troubleshooting, and traffic identification. Conditional access. This enables organizations to define specific conditions on how users authenticate and gain access. This feature is natively supported in Edge and no need for any extensions. Endpoint DLP. This is out of preview and was made available in October. This feature, natively supported in Edge, helps companies identify and protect sensitive information. No need for any third-party extension. Now that we've covered what has been available in Edge for security, let's talk about what's new. As of Build 88, Microsoft Edge offers a built-in strong password generator. You can use this generator when signing up for a new account or when changing a password. Just look for the browser-suggested password dropdown in the password field. When selected, it will automatically save to the browser and sync across devices. Password Monitor. The underlying technology ensures privacy and security of the user's passwords, which means that neither Microsoft nor any other party can learn the user's passwords while they are being monitored. Password Monitor scans for matches on your behalf and is on by default, and notifies the user if they need to change their password. Now that we've talked about all the security features customers love, let's move into features users love. At the end of the day, we are all users of the browser, regardless of where we sit at our companies. 2020 found us all working differently. Microsoft published some research in January that showed how our workday changed during this time. The workday expanded by at least 3 hours, lunch hours went away, and weekends were shortened. We found ourselves living at work and our work machines always available and in front of us. I saw many people who had been working remotely for years before 2020 communicate this was not working from home, but rather living at work. And personal browsing increased on work machines. When a machine is in front of you and you need to do something in a browser, it doesn't really matter if it's a work machine or if it's during work hours. You want to complete that task. Edge has the features needed for both personal and work needs. Let's go through these features to show how useful they are for during your workday or before and after your workday. In previous research, we have often found that users use multiple browsers to separate browsing for their roles. With Edge, you can have a profile for each of your roles to keep your work and personal browsing separate without needing to use another browser. Some other common use cases we have seen for using multiple profiles are school and personal, multiple people using the same device, work and admin tasks, consultants, and work and dev testing. We know that separating profiles can be hard to enforce, and so we've tried to make it easier in Edge. Automatic profile switching will prompt you to switch profiles when you detect that you're trying to access work content from your personal profile. You can also pick a default profile for external links. And while some end users love the ability to have multiple profiles, we also received feedback from people who don't need or care to separate out their profiles. For these people, if they were logged in with a Microsoft account in an Edge profile and trying to access a work site, conditional access requirements wouldn't allow them to access that site. As of build 88, we have a new feature available. On a managed device, you can choose the last option under Profiles Preferences, Allow SSO for work or school sites using this profile. In addition, we are working on multiple profiles for progressive web apps. If you install the same site or PWA on more than one Microsoft Edge profile, we've introduced a profile switcher on the application title bar. You can switch between profiles from within your app. For your work dashboard, we've introduced a new feature as of build 88 called Your Day at a Glance. This is enabled by default. This offers users signed in with their work or school account personalized and relevant content powered by M365 Graph. Users can quickly scan the Your Day at a Glance section to easily track meetings, recent work, or quickly launch apps they want to use. With Microsoft Search, users can search both the internet and intranet through this feature. It enables your employees to search for files, colleagues, or internal sites with simple search terms straight from the browser. Remember, the results are owned by your company and not shared with Microsoft and not available on the internet. This is all powered by the Microsoft Graph. Admins can easily customize the experience with bookmarks, Q&As, acronyms, locations, and more. This feature is available with your M365 subscription and built right into Edge. In addition, you might be surprised by how much search can improve daily work life for your employees. An estimated 5 to 10 days a year is saved by employees, and this feature has been found to reduce support tickets 30 to 60%. Edge brings your corporate information closer to employees through Microsoft Search and is a low-effort way to have a huge impact on your organization. Now you can sync your history and tabs in addition to favorites, passwords, and autofill information. This is available on desktop and mobile to all customers who are signed in with the same profile. To enable history and open tab sync, go to Edge Settings, Profiles, Sync, and turn on the toggles. Collections allows you to save a URL, images, or text from a web page. It also allows you to write your own notes and comments. We've received great feedback regarding collections. Users love the ease of use. Based on feedback, we've made improvements. We've added in an add button. Just hover over any collection, click the plus icon, and it will be added to the current page of collections. Users are always asking for better tab management features, and vertical tabs helps and has been a top hit with users. On the left-hand side of the address bar, click the rectangle box, and your tabs move to the vertical and not horizontal. Click again, and you're back to the horizontal tabs. Smart Copy makes it easier to select, copy, and paste the exact content you want from the web and preserve the rich web format. You can use your cursor to select any area or type of content. When you paste, it will retain the formatting, including any images or links. Having to reformat anything is a pain, so this feature is amazing. Currently available in preview channels. Sleeping tabs is a feature that we've had in preview for a while, but good news, this is now broadly available as of build 89. When you have several tabs open, it will release system resources for inactive tabs to help power new or existing tabs, as well as other applications. This prevents slowdowns and sluggishness. Using sleeping tabs on Microsoft Edge typically reduces memory usage by 32% on average. It also increases your battery life, as a sleeping tab uses 37% less CPU on average than a non-sleeping tab. And we've got PDF built right into Microsoft Edge, which has you covered with everything from inking and accessibility to security features. Now that we've talked about the security features the security teams love and the end user features that they love, let's move to features that IT admins love. Let's be honest, we all need to make life easier for all the admins in our lives. Let's start with IE mode. IE mode provides a native experience designed for maximum IE11 compatibility. This enables customers to use a single browser for both modern apps and sites and legacy line of business sites. We have new areas to talk about for IE mode. Ability to share cookies between Microsoft Edge and IE, a policy allowing enterprises to disable IE11 without impacting IE mode, and the ability to associate file types in IE mode. Microsoft Endpoint Manager. Edge is fully manageable in MEM. We have some new features to talk about there as well. Target version override is available. Rollback to previous versions is also available. And Intune integration with kiosk mode. And finally, App Configuration Policies, or ACP. This feature applies settings or policies which take effect anytime the user associated that account with a profile without the need to manage the device. We have a public preview targeted for Q2 of 2021. Edge and IE processes don't share session cookies. This can be annoying if a user has to re-auth in IE mode or when signing out of an Edge session and doesn't sign out of an IE mode session. Think of different transactions that need different user logins. The user has to re-auth each time. We've made that easier. You can now share cookies from Microsoft Edge to IE. You can configure cookie sharing in the sitelist XML. You can now use the Enterprise Sitelist Manager in Edge directly in the browser. You no longer need to use the standalone Sitelist Manager tool. Once you enable the group policy, you'll see the option Enterprise Sitelist Manager under Edge :\compat. We've heard from customers that they want a way to prevent end users to open IE11. That muscle memory is a hard thing to change. Great news, a policy is available in the OS that allows IT admins to disable IE11 without affecting IE mode. Enabling this policy prevents IE11 from launching, restricts IE's usage to IE mode, redirects all attempts at launching IE11 to Edge stable channel, and overrides any other policy that redirects to IE11. You can now associate file extensions in IE mode. This feature allows you to open local files in IE mode without the site list. How cool is that? It is intended to be used through Windows Explorer's Open with Context menu. You can open file extensions such as MHT, HTM, XML, and Visio documents as examples. As you can see from the video, the user wants to open an XML file. Right-click, Open with Edge in IE mode, and there you go. You can see in the next tab the user is in IE mode with the IE icon in the address bar. With this new feature, combined with the previous policy of disabling IE11, you can default to IE mode if you have any reliance on specific file extensions. You can confidently get rid of IE11 in your environment. Good news, kiosk mode is generally available as of March 2021 and includes assigned access single app support and integration with Intune. For more details, check out our kiosk mode video at ak.ms/edge-youtube. Some Microsoft properties announced the end of support for IE11. Check out the list on the slide and make sure you are ready. These properties all work on Edge and IE11 isn't needed. Thank you so much for listening about why end users and IT admins love Edge. We've covered a lot of information. Please check out these resources. And I love to hear from customers. Feel free to reach out to me on Twitter, and thank you so much.